Right, thank you for staying with us. It's still sports tonight, and we're still talking about the Rio Olympic Games. But let me just quickly introduce to you my partners for the second part of the show. Yemi Adebayo is on the show. Oye Wuchiwajoku is also around. Guys, a lot for us to talk about. Let's focus quickly on the stories coming out of the Olympic Games. Let me get your thoughts very quickly. While this is going on, let's also tell you that we are hoping that we can connect with Austin Okonapan, who is in Rio. That's our correspondent in Rio, so that we can hook up with him and find out exactly if he'll be able to give us updates. But guys, while we wait for Austin to connect with us, let's reflect on some of the issues that we've talked about earlier on. Aruna Quadri, by all expectations, surpassing his own expectations. But then, against the world number one, we felt that the impossible would happen, but it came short.
No shame.
No shame in losing to the world number one.
And that's why it was rightly commended by the African Table Tennis Federation president. Even defeat in the round that took him to the quarterfinal was the biggest upset in Olympic history. I couldn't bear to watch the game. I was just waiting for the results. And Malone just showed us why he has been there for 2 years.
Why is
world number one? And at some point, you could see that Aruna Quadri was... I think he just... You know, it was demoralized. You know, it wasn't there in any of the four sets. It wasn't near him.
But they got up in class.
Yeah, it was just obvious. But it's good. It's good that he got to rub shoulders with the best. And what this tells us is he's in the top eight bracket. That's just what he means. And I'm happy.
It's quality.
Yes.
The rankings may put him 20-something.
But his quality shows
his
us.
His quality is in the top eight.
He's in the top eight. And I think that's where he should be looking forward to be. This guy just epitomizes the Nigerian, the spirit of the Nigerian against all odds. And he soldiered on, battled hard. I'm happy for him. I would have loved to see a medal around his neck. He still has a chance with the team's event. Hopefully, something will come out of there. But for the singles, I mean, that's where the story ends. It's been a fairy tale run, but it has to end. Not a happy ending, but not a sad one either.
Looking at the story of Aruna Quadri and how he started and how he sacrificed, sponsored himself to some of these major qualifiers for the Olympic Games, you could probably say it has paid up for him. At some point, remember on this show, we said it a lot of times, he will pay his way through and do all of that. Now he's made a record of being the first African to play in the quarterfinal, and I'm sure by the time the next IWTF rankings are out, this guy could be knocking on the door of the top 10.
Yeah, totally agree with you, Tony. I watched Aruna Quadri after the game, the interview he had with journalists, and he said he was impressed, he was satisfied with his performance. This is his second Olympic Games, and getting to the quarterfinal shows tremendous improvement. From the last Olympic Games at Sydney, 4 years ago. So, he doesn't have anything to be ashamed of. What it means is that with the right program, with the right
support,
this guy, the next Olympic Games, can go further than what he has achieved, at this game. So, for me, I really like the way he has been commended by the table tennis body in Africa. Even the minister, visited him after the games.
Before the games against
Malong. Took pictures with the table tennis contingent, and that is what we are saying. We need to encourage these athletes when they lose and when they win, so that in future they can get the needed support. For Aruna Quadri, he remains our brightest hope to him. He's younger than Segun Toriola. He has just gone to his second Olympic Games, and who knows, if he get the right support like we've been clamoring for, then he can get the gold or silver at the next Olympic Games.
All right, guys, let's move away from table tennis. Let's talk about rowing. Let's talk about rowing now. Yesterday on the show, there was a lot about Chiarika Okogu and our qualification for the semifinals. But we have clarification now that semifinal that she's qualified for is not for a medal. It's not to win a medal. is just to classify.
Classification.
Well, it could be good for her to find out how well she has done for herself.
It's a yardstick to judge performance.
How well she's performed in the world. Maybe she's going to be in the top 10 in the world. That's going to be good for her personally.
Yeah.
But for the Olympic Games, no medal.
Yeah.
Chiarika Okogwu. And then the event actually itself has been postponed because of high winds, Yemi.
Force of nature.
Mm.
Nobody can do anything about that. And of course, since the event has been cancelled, we'll have to wait to see. We'll have to wait till Friday, to decide who wins and for the classification. It's of interest to us because it's a good yardstick for her to measure her performance, how far she has gone, and to judge what she needs to do to be where she wants to be. But in our own,
you could see that the weather wasn't clement at all.
It wasn't friendly, and everybody had to leave. Talking about Chiarika, I think in our hearts she's a winner. This is a sport. A year or two ago, all of us would have said there's no Nigeria that would probably participate, and she has brought Nigeria, put us on the global stage for doing this event. And I'm hoping that she doesn't give up. I'm hoping she gets all the support that she needs.
You're hoping that this is a launch pad.
Yeah, so that she
doesn't begin to go into sports like this.
So that
Nigeria
athletes like this would tend to do all by themselves. We should just, whenever we see athletes showing interest, even like we said yesterday, even when we don't have the facilities to support them here, if it is grants, if it is go to college that you can get scholarship, you know, all the necessary support. And I always keep pointing to the Jamaicans, how they seem to have usurped the American collegiate system. And the Americans are sitting there asking themselves that the money that we are bringing into these states, you see, the Jamaicans are the ones benefiting the most. And so all of those things are the things we need to look at.
Mm. All right, let's move away from rowing now and talk about our basketball team. The basketball team played a much better game.
Yes.
Than the one they played against Argentina, but the fact of the case is that they lost their second game in a row. Yeah. 9 points to Lithuania, one of the top in the top five in the world. We could have done a lot better, really, but we lost it in the third quarter.
Yeah.
Because we won the first quarter. We were leading by halftime by 4 points, and then we just crumbled in the third quarter. We tried to fight back in the last quarter, but it was a little too late.
Yeah, I think loss of concentration. When it matters most, you have to, you know, keep focus when you are playing against a team like Lithuania. When you are leading, you also have to ensure that you sustain the momentum. And the Tigers didn't do that. And, you know, fortunately, they have lost the second game, too. And it's getting tougher.
Mm.
It's getting tougher.
We are bottom place with Spain.
Yeah. Yeah.
We are bottom of the group.
Yeah.
It's not totally their hands.
Yeah, but we can still win 3 games. That will still be good enough for us to finish in the top 4.
Yeah,
but then can we win 3 games?
That is a big question. But the way they have improved after the game against Argentina, you know, if they continue to
Spain, Croatia, if they continue
to make that improvement, then, you know, they believe in themselves. And the American too should also, you know, prove why we have brought him on board. You know, we brought him on board to, you know, to help us get very far.
But losing 9 points to a team in the top 5, for me, is some improvement.
I don't know. I thought there was an X factor against Lithuania. He was putting that out on Monday. Lithuania was one of the teams I thought we were going to beat, irrespective of their ranking, because we've done it before. And you know, when we were leading, I was thinking it was going to happen. But they had one or two challenges, injuries, and I think they just gassed out. I think that's what happened. For whatever reasons, I do not know. But we'll see. We still have Spain, Brazil, and Croatia. So we'll see what happens. But like I said, it's not totally. But I'm just hoping we're able to get out of that group and win the next three. This one was close. The one against Argentina, because all of the issues of our margin start coming into it as well. So not only do you need to win by how you lose sometimes too. All of those are factors. But winning outright the next three matches will go a long way in ensuring that we get out of the group. And hopefully some of the teams that have beaten us will meet other teams too that will probably knock them off their seat.
Mm. All right, so that's it for the basketball. Our next game is against Spain. That's a must win for us because Nigeria and Spain are the two bottom teams in that group. So it's more like a relegation dogfight, if I can use that word. And so we have to try to get something against in that game against Spain. Is it a possibility? Yes, it's possible. But can we bring it to bring our A game on that day? I mean, the coach, the boys will have to do that.
Even Spain, I don't understand what has happened to the Spaniards.
I
hope they will get themselves played against us. Because man for man, you want to think that Spain is better.
Of course, they have better players. All right, so we wish the basketball team all the best of luck. Guys, before we go on a break, let's talk football very quickly. In a few minutes from now, an hour and a half from now, we should be playing Colombia. For us, it's just formality. We've won the group. We have 6 points and we are through to the quarterfinals. Coach Samson Siasia is playing with a lot of fresh players. He wants to keep his team fresh. So he's made 5 changes, Yemi, to the squad I'll be playing today. Shehu Abdullahi will be resting. Stanley Amuzie is resting.
Daniel Akweye in goal.
Akweye is in goal. And we have
Umar Aminu starting.
Boko Ola is starting, and Aminu Umar is starting. All right, so those are the 5 new guys in the team. The core of the team is still there.
Yeah, I think it's good. It would be good to go to the Olympics and not get a game under your belt. These guys are in a position that you want your team to be. Irrespective of what happens today, we're still the best. And it even gives us the leverage to be looking at what's happening in the other group. And so
for me tonight, it's all about deciding who we are meeting in the quarterfinals because the other group will also be concluding. And yeah. So what do we want? We don't have any choice now. Whoever finishes second in the group
is
who we are going to meet. And that's a tough one, Onye, because
if it's Brazil,
Rose, Denmark, South Africa, everybody's still in it in that group.
Yeah. All the 4 teams in Group A are still contenders for the quarterfinal tickets. For me, I think Siasia and his boys should be prepared for anything. You know, if you say you're going to prefer Denmark, well, we also reflected that Denmark beat us 6-2. Though you can argue that some of the players, top players, were not in that friendly. Then, if you want Brazil, you also
consider that you're playing against the host.
Against the host team, man, is it the issue?
And there's a Neymar in that team.
Yeah, the fact that they drew has been rubbish, like the likes of Portugal drew. Almost all their
even Nigeria in 2013, AFCON. First game, a draw. Second game, a draw. But then from then on,
from after Ethiopia,
Italy and Roots winning the 1982 World Cup.
Draw.
Yeah. When it got to the game against Brazil,
everything changed.
Started winning.
So playing against the host is not something that you really want.
You should be thinking about winning whoever.
But I like the spirit that Siasia is approaching all of this with. He says, look, I want to take it one game at a time. Right now, I'm focusing on my game today against Colombia. After the game against Colombia, then I start to look at what next.
This scenario reminds me of France 98, where we were supposed to play Paraguay, but we're busy thinking of the next round.
We had qualified before the last game.
Yes. That's why I said, same scenario, we had qualified for the last game. So we're not even thinking of who we're going to play the second round.
Yeah.
We're thinking of the quarterfinal against Brazil.
Against Brazil.
And so that's what I don't want us
to. We didn't concentrate on Denmark.
We still had one knockout game to play. We're not talking about it.
But we're thinking of Brazil already. And so we need to take our game seriously, starting from tonight. We shouldn't be complacent at all. Victory is good, irrespective of the fact that we've qualified. It doesn't matter that we're first. Victory is good. It takes good anytime. And I'll take victory tonight. And so whoever comes our way, Denmark, Iraq, South Africa, Brazil, I would prefer not to play against Brazil. But if it happens that we're playing against Brazil, well, who cares? As long as we win. Nobody cares. At the end of the day, if we win.
You don't have a choice now. Yeah. You have topped the group.
Yes.
So you've got to wait for the team that finishes second in Group A. All right. So we really have to be careful what we wish for. Mm-hmm. Because you could go and wish for a country that will eventually become too difficult for you to handle. But I think the spirit is we prepare whoever comes our way. Since we have topped the group, we have no choice than to wait for the team that will finish in second place. And for us, we have to take it one game at a time. And I believe that we can take anybody out if we play our A game on the day. All right? Guys, before we go on a break, let me just quickly go to Twitter now and read a few of the comments. Our good friend Ola Yinka Ule was talking about the All-Stars. Okay? I'm told I have to go on the break right now. We'll come back from the break. I'll read your comments on Twitter, and there's plenty more for you on Sports Tonight. Join us again.